Today we're in Mankato with our friends at Snell Motor Company, offering fine Buick, GMC, and Cadillac vehicles.
So here we are once again in the 2019 Buick Regal TourX, and we are just out for a ride. So Rob and I have done a little bit of driving. We drove out a little ways to do another part of the review. So we've had a little time in the car, but not a whole lot. So, you know, Rob, you can start because it's your driving. I know. What are any impressions? Oh, it's your lane.
Oh, is okay.
Yep, we can turn that off.
I heard some beeping there. That's what it was, folks.
Lane departure warnings.
I'm really impressed that it's really quiet in here and it's very maneuverable. When I think Buick, you know, when I'm younger and I'm thinking, oh, they're the big sleds from the 70s and they just kind of wallow around the corners and they just pitch and sway front to back. No, not on this car. It's very maneuverable. If it didn't have the Buick emblem anywhere on the vehicle, I would definitely think I was in a more European car.
Yeah, I like the handling on it. The steering wheel seems just right. The assist on it seems just right.
Yeah, it's
easy
just
easy to steer in town, but when you get the highway, a little firmer.
Boosted just enough to let you still feel the road. How dare I say, similar to the that BM something company in Germany that is known for their handling. This is very, very...
This is very nice.
I'm pleasantly surprised.
I like the quietness of the ride.
Yeah.
And the ability to have that extra space in the room, especially when you fold down the seats. I mean, it's big with the seats up, but when you fold down the seats, you get a lot more room in there.
Okay, I just noticed something, Nathan. Heated steering wheel. I love it.
Oh, yeah. The heated steering wheel, for our area of the country, that is really a nice thing.
That's so cool.
The adaptive cruise control is really nice as well. And then the ability to have the navigation display in your driver's information center with its kind of turn-by-turn directions is nice.
Oh, it does? Okay.
Yeah. There is a Buick app that you can get. There's one that comes, there's three ways to connect to it with the app. First way is free for 10 years, and that basically gives you diagnostics on your vehicle.
Okay.
Marketplace, and then if you step up to the next level, it's like $14.99 a month or $149.99 for the year. That gives you all the remote unlock, lock functions from your phone.
Okay.
And then you can set up to the unlimited plan, which gives you all the features that are offered.
Okay. What are these for?
Those will scroll through your media.
Okay. Oh, you turned the steering wheel on.
No, it's like your
my steering wheel's good. Now you turned it on.
I thought you had it on already. I turned it off and then I turned it back on because I thought you had it on.
What's going on here? Oh, here the steering wheel's on.
It's some of the chrome trim is a little bright, like down around, like around the shifter.
Yeah, I'm getting a glare
right now, I'm getting a glare in my eyes from it.
Yeah,
it'd be nice if that were maybe a dulled surface, so it's not
make
quite
it
that
more
reflective.
Of a brush. Make right, it more I mean, satin.
It's a very nice look, but right now with the sun coming through the windshield, I'm definitely getting. I'm putting my hand over it because it's blinding my eyes.
Right.
On the blind spot warning on this car. The Buick has added an interesting feature. I would call it enhanced blind spot monitoring. So it does exactly what blind spot monitoring is supposed to do. It lights up in the mirror when the car's next to you, right?
Right.
But this also has an added feature where it uses a sensor to see cars that are a little further behind you that are coming up that are potential danger. They're maybe just getting into your lane.
Okay.
Maybe they're approaching really fast, and then it warns you. So in the mirror, you'll notice a car and a star.
I saw that, yeah.
So that's kind of what's going to tell you that it has the enhanced feature. Buick has another name for it, but okay. Basically I would look at it as enhanced blind spot monitoring, which is a really neat feature. All soft touch materials on the top here.
Is that real stitching? It looks, I swear it looks like it.
If it isn't, it sure feels like it.
Yeah, if it isn't, it's a very good interpretation of it in molded plastic.
Yep.
Because it looks real.
Case.
I'm very impressed overall with the vehicle. It's a vehicle we said we were going to review, and I really came into it not with a negative opinion, but it wasn't a super positive opinion either. I was kind of, if you're on a scale to, you know, from minus 10 to plus 10, I was probably like a minus 1 thinking, it's just a Buick, really? But it doesn't drive like my thought of a Buick would be like. And it's actually a really, really quiet car. Very, very zippy. Love the handling.
Oh, yeah.
It's got a lot of, it's got a lot of comfort.
And the seatbelts work really good.
Gonna try this again?
Rob likes to do the braking, then tell me he's, we're gonna test the braking as I'm hanging
on. Man, I got that in the wrong order again. I was supposed to say hold on, and then we're gonna brake. I always just brake and then say hold on.
But, for a stage wagon, this just handles really nice.
We're sitting up here. I forgot. I thought I was in a sedan.
Yeah, well. You know, sometimes you forget where we are in a matter of seconds, so that's not a big surprise. No, I'm joking.
One of the things, too, though...
It handles nimbly. It's nice.
One of the things, though, that is different, because, you know, we have... we've done some car reviews, but the majority of what we've done have been, like, trucks and SUVs, because those are the most popular vehicles out there, and people really want to see them. But it was kind of cool to get back into something different by being a car that is also a four-wheel drive, all-wheel drive wagon. You do sit lower... we're back in the height of a car. So, you know, your view out isn't as good. Can I go that way? I can't go that way.
Nope.
This lane, can I?
Nope.
I got in the wrong lane. Okay, yeah, we'll drive a little bit more.
It's all right.
But your view out, of course, is lower, and it's narrower and seems a little tighter inside, even though that's how the cockpit kind of wraps around you. It's not really smaller. It's just that it's a car, and it's not a big, wide SUV.
Yeah, it's different from the cars we normally drive, but it is roomy. Don't have any problems with...
it's not cramped.
The side... Oh, my... No.
No.
So, you know, overall, I'm impressed by the car. If you were to step in and take it for a test drive, I think you'd find the same things that we've talked about. It's got really zippy acceleration. You kind of have to do floor to get to that point, and then it really goes.
Right.
It's responsive... without stepping on it, but if you put it to the floor, it really goes. Braking is good. My neck rash will tell me later. Seating's comfortable. You'll notice some of the chrome trim on the bottom is really reflective, and that's you know, we wish, you know, maybe it'll make a plastic piece you could put over this, like a tinted film or something that would dull that a little bit. On an aftermarket product, but right. The handling is nice. I'm impressed.
And one thing I like, I hear a little bit of the engine, it's a four-cylinder, so you hear a little bit of the drone, but not bad at all. It's this acoustic windshield and the sound deadening that a Buick is known for is definitely here, and it really makes this a quiet car.